Welcome to howtocookgreatfood.com.
Hi, welcome to howtocookgreatfood.com. Today I'm going to be making a classic cream of chicken soup. As you can see down the front there, I've got some chicken legs. I've got three chicken legs. I've got some bay leaves. I've got quite a few onions, sort of four medium onions. Then next to that, I've got some potatoes with a sprinkling of carrot on the top. That's just like one carrot and about four potatoes. In the center, I've got some chopped garlic, some black pepper, some salt, a little pinch of thyme, and a little pinch of sweet dried basil. This is a pretty standard soup. It's going to take us a little while to make. It's not super easy, this one, because we're going to get the chicken cooked for a long time before we add any vegetables. We're going to use a few other bits and pieces, butter, oil, of course some cream. Let's get moving. Okay, so I've got a regular pan here. I've got a little touch of oil, which I'm heating up. It's getting nice and hot now. Also got a nice knob of butter we're going to drop in there and melt that down. As that's melting, we can put our chicken straight in. Now you can use any part of the chicken, as long as it has a bone. The bone is quite important to what we're doing. We need to get it cooked really down nicely and get all those flavours out of the bone. So a fillet of chicken would be useless in this dish, to be honest. Okay, so I've got a few bay leaves. What else have I got here? Some salt and pepper. A little bit of the thyme and the sweet basil, only a little pinch, and then my chopped garlic. That's super. Alright, I'm going to put the lid on that. I just want to cook that for 5 minutes, then we'll add a few more bits and pieces to it. See you in about 5 minutes. Okay, let's have a look now. Oh, that's lovely. It smells amazing. I wish you could smell this. Lovely. All those flavours have gone straight into that chicken now. Yeah, looking great. Now, simply, I'm going to put water in. I don't use stock. I don't really like stock cubes and soap. I want this to be the stock. So here we go. Be careful because you've got oil and water about to mix here, which is never a good thing. So now, bring this to the boil, and then I'm going to simmer it. We'll simmer this for about at least half an hour. The effect we want is we want all of the meat to fall off the bone. We'll then take the bones out, then we can get on to the next stage. So, and that's going to really, you know, that's going to really sort of create the stock and the actual chicken flavour. That's why I said you must use chicken with some form of bone in it. Okay, so bring it to the boil, cook it for at least half an hour. I'll pop back then and tell you what to do next. See you then. Okay, let's take a look at this now. It's been on 30 minutes, 40 minutes in fact. As you can see, it's reduced quite a lot. And that chicken's nice and loose in there now, it's coming away. And what we need to do now is take the chicken out. Take the whole lot out there. I've got a few of those bay leaves as well. We can get them out now as well. There you go. They're all out now, I think. And we need to set this aside, this chicken, and let it cool down. And then with our hands, we'll take everything off the bone, the meat, which we'll put in again later. So what we're left with now is an incredibly beautiful, and it smells great, stock here. That's the basis of our soup now. So we simply now add our onions. And our potatoes and our carrots. I may well add a little bit more water to this because it's going to be quite thick. But once this is cooked down, the potatoes will actually add to the thickness. Some people use flour to make a chicken soup, or powdered milk even. We're using potatoes to sort of create our starch and thickness. So let's just boil this up, bring it to the boil, and then again simmer it until it's very, very soft. Like I always say, in a kind of baby food fashion. We need to be able to liquidize it. So, lid back on, the heat's on high. Once it boils, I'll reduce the heat down to a rolling boil. We're letting our chicken cool down. Once that's done, I'm gonna pick all of the meat off the bone. We'll be back here, I reckon, in about 20 minutes. See you then. Okay, let's take a look at this. Potatoes are still fairly hard and the carrots. I'm just gonna add a little bit more water to top this up. Just a touch, wasn't that much there. Okay then, so we'll come back. Let's have a look. Yeah, we need another 15 minutes on this, I think, to soften all of these vegetables. See you in a little bit. Okay, let's take a look here. Okay, this is fine. This is mashing down quite easily. All right, so let's just turn this off for a moment. And then I'm gonna use my trusty blender. You can use a different one, a traditional one that you pour it into. I find this much more convenient. So let me now these vegetables are nice and soft, let me liquidize this and I'll come back once it's done. See you in a minute. Okay, there you are. That is a lovely, lovely consistency. If it was too thick, you could add a little bit of stock or water. Water in our case, so you can see that's absolutely perfect. That really is good. What I'm gonna do now, you see I've got the chicken that we had earlier. I've taken it all off the bone, taking any bits and pieces out that we don't need. There's just lovely chicken there. The soup itself, that's a fantastic chicken smell, because remember we made all of that fantastic stock. These extra bits just add a little bit of meatiness, of course, to it. Okay, you can taste this now for salt if it needs salt. In my opinion, that is fantastic. Only one more thing to do. You could add a little bit of cream if you wanted, but not necessary. I might do it in a minute, but just delicious, fantastic, classic chicken soup. We'll see you again next time. Take care, bye-bye.
howtocookgreatfood.com. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel.